Welcome to the show. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. According to the document on my screen, this is show number 619, and we're all back in the studio. I've got Jeffrey over there.
Hi,
Jeffrey.
I had the craziest dream. We used to get together every week and talk about games.
And do a little audio showgram.
Yeah, it's deja vu.
Sitting across from you is Laura.
Hello.
Hello, Laura Lollipop. Nice
Good to see you.
It's a pleasure. We're all back in the studio. We've you were just commenting before we started rolling tape that we haven't been in here in a while.
It's been a long time.
Yeah, it's been so long that I put this on Twitter. We actually have new microphones. I ordered a whole set of new microphones.
You did.
They evolved. So, while we were gone,
yeah,
these are
Laura. You pegged them there. The RE30s,
yes,
which are the Electro Voice. I used to use the RE, the little brother of these in radio, RE20s. So hopefully our voice sounds better.
The show is already 30% better.
Can you feel it?
I think everyone out there can
you feel it?
It.
We're great to be back. It's been a crazy. When was the last time we did the last show?
I can't even remember.
It was actually a video show that we did back in March. So
God.
We were gone all in April because I was on holiday.
Mm-hmm.
You were on. I was on annual leave.
I was on holiday.
You were on holiday. Jeff was.
I was going around the world.
You were too busy.
Showing off. Well, I was working on State of Decay. Working State of Decay 2.
That wasn't the most. That was important, but that wasn't the real reason. What you were doing. You were busy with This Week on Xbox.
Oh, well, yes. Every time Larry leaves, I do it. And then the first week, everyone's like, oh, Larry's on break. And then the second week, everyone's like, what did you do with Larry? If you think you're replacing him, you've got another thing coming.
Now I will say this is an internet. I apologize in advance for this, Jeffrey. If Jeff is not available and I'm not asking the internet to take a hit out on him, then Laura, we're going to put you in the show and you're going to do Inside Xbox.
All right. Well, this is like in Far Cry. It's like, you've been marked.
Yeah, exactly.
They're coming for me.
So anyway, great to see everybody. We'll talk about what we did during April, which was we did PAX.
That's right.
Wow,
I missed that.
Wow, we're all the way back at PAX. We're snowed.
I don't even barely remember that anymore.
We're snowed and Jeffrey and I had terrible bagels.
Bagels?
The worst. From a place called, wait for it, Better Bagels. Better than what?
Better than
Dante's Inferno.
Oh, no.
Do we want to do news first? Do we want to go into some of the stuff we've been up to? How do we want to do this?
Let's catch up. Everyone wants to know where you were.
Okay. Well, first of all, we did PAX. We talked about PAX, which was great. Laura, you were missed.
You got to play PUBG with Deadmau5
and Brendan Green.
And Brendan Green is Deadmau5. I know that. I just like to say that.
So we did that.
It's what I do.
We did that. We had a great time there and we talked about the bagels that Laura, we waited 20 minutes at this Better Bagel place.
20 minutes for
which
great
is fine.
Bagels.
No, which is fine. We're like, okay, get the bagel. And then we get the bagel. It's not even toasted.
They got literally everything wrong. I had to break it down in a series of Instagram stories.
Jeff has a violent dislike for onions.
That's accurate.
And,
really?
And they had he had onions on his
the devil's herb.
So. Oh, really?
So anyway,
so good.
But it was I agree with you, Laura.
I was in your town.
Have you had them caramelized?
I do not like them in a box. I do not like them with a fox.
Do not like them anywhere he goes.
Yes.
So anyway, so we did that. Then I came back. We did Inside Xbox in early March,
yes,
April.
Yes, they watched that.
Which was our great show. Jeffrey and I host that. We have another one coming up in a few weeks.
Yeah, I can't wait.
We'll have details on that next week.
That's pretty cool.
Can't talk about that. And then I said, you know what? I'm going away.
Should
I tell everybody where I went?
Sailing.
Well, you tweeted it.
Well, did I? Kind of. I was kind of a little, wasn't real clear. I went to Maui. Was in Hawaii with my wife and daughter. I took paternity leave for a few weeks in Maui. We got a lot of paternity leave to take, and I only took a little bit of it. So went over there and lived on Maui for a week or 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and had some fun.
That's right.
Right? Do you want to talk about what you did, or you don't want to talk about that?
Yeah, I can say that I also saw you in Maui.
So
what? Hey guys, let me check my spam filter. I didn't get the invitation.
No. Laura and I.
It just happened.
It just happened to be over there at the same time. We're like, wait, what?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It happened to schedule around the same time.
Yep.
So we met up, and I got to meet the little one.
Yeah,
oh, really?
My daughter.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of fun. So.
And The Rock, I'm like waiting for a picture of you.
Well, it's funny. Laura and I were on the island at the same time, and we saw each other only for that 20 minutes or so. I mean, it was because you were doing your thing, and I was doing my thing. But let's be clear. We had quite the conversation going back and forth about various things.
Like, have you gotten the shrimp out of this truck?
Right.
And have you had the Kahlua pork over
here? Have you had the pie
here?
At this place?
Where is the sun? I'm going scuba diving. Do you want to go? You know, all of that kind of stuff. I did scuba dive. It was great.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
How far down did you go?
I think my I think my I dropped down to about 85.
Oh my, there's no way. Yeah. I just like thinking about that like makes me sweat.
Well, the scuba diving is phenomenal in Maui because it's Maui.
Right.
We were to Molokini, saw some, went down. Well, it's funny, as I told Laura, should I tell this? I'll tell the story.
Yeah.
I told Laura this story that we went down to Molokini, which is a crater off of part of Maui, and you go down and dive and it's beautiful. And you come up and then you get the boat and you go to the next location, which mm-hmm. is probably a half hour, 40 minutes away, and your body's kind of getting ready. And so we pull up, we drop anchor, and there's a bunch of paddlers, canoers out there.
Yeah.
You know, probably 200 feet off the boat. And the lead comes over, this woman, she paddles over, say, hey guys, I know you're going diving, but just a heads up, we were just over there, and she points over, there's a reef. She says, we just saw a shark over there, a tiger shark.
A tiger shark.
But it shouldn't bother you because it was busy eating another shark.
Why? Why would you do this? Well, the ocean is for them, not for us.
So I get in there.
You still went in.
Yeah, so they still went in. My response was, yeah, let's jump in.
See, at that point, I would have had a wetsuit from the inside.
Now, I jump in, and I was like, okay, now, because I've been in the water with sharks before.
Okay.
That was the first time where I had a panic attack. But, yeah, but I get in the exactly. water, and we go down, and it was all turtles and sea rays, and quickly you forgot about the fact that you could be dinner.
Yeah.
But it was nice to be in Maui. It was great to see you, Laura, of course.
Yes, great to see you and your daughter.
And it was a lot of fun.
But what did you play while you were there? Any games? Did
no.
you bring anything?
I did not play.
A lifeline?
Nothing.
Bring a Switch? A
nothing.
Phone?
Although it was interesting is where we were staying is the lifeguards were Xbox fans.
Oh, that's
so cool. Every day we went out to the pool with my daughter and we talked video games and Far Cry, and because I had finished, you know, I'd started that. I hadn't finished mm-hmm. it. But it was just a lovely time out there. Anytime, I highly recommend it. Right, Laura?
Yeah, it's great.
Well, it's Laura.
I recommend it as
Laura
well.
Proves it. Larry proves it. Jeff, you've been to Maui.
No.
You've been
in the first. What do you mean? Why?
Have you
that's
been
like
to Hawaii?
That's the thing. Like everybody does.
He's been to Oahu.
I did. Yeah, and I went to Kauai once. But yeah, I've only been out there twice.
Well, it's funny because Laura and I were just texting this morning because Hawaii, the Big Island, mm-hmm. Just erupted. What was it?
Kilauea.
So I've not been.
Putting the kill in Kilauea. Apparently,
it was. So I'd love.
I've been there a few times, and every time I'm there, it's not erupting.
Well, it's
now it's erupting.
It's awake.
It's awake.
I would love to go diving there because I want to go diving where the lava comes into the ocean.
Oh my gosh, that'd be amazing.
Why are you looking at me with such horror?
I don't know. Maybe I'm. It's just like it's not for me. That just
have you
freaks
tried
me
it?
Out. I've been snorkeling, and that was like a bit much. I almost drowned once. So.
Well, let's be clear. You don't prefer the water sports. You prefer the mountain sports. The snow.
Yeah, that's true.
Which is fine.
I do. I enjoy.
We all have our different
the snowboards.
Anyway.
I like if you froze the ocean and then piled it up into a pile, and I could go down it reasonably quickly. I'm in.
Anyway, I don't want to talk too much about that because you guys want to hear about games. But if you want to hear any more, if you have any questions about that, feel free to hit me up on Twitter at Major Nelson, and I will.
All your recommendations.
I will say this: if you can, and Laura knows this, if you can. Go to Haleakala.
Can you spell that?
It is the tallest mountain in Maui. It's like 10,000 feet.
Pictures for that.
And it's a national park.
You know
it
what?
Is.
I'm gonna link out to that. In the
could
show
you please?
There's
as soon as I can figure out how to spell it.
Isn't there a plant that only grows on that mountain?
Oh, there may be. I don't know.
I think it's called the silver sword or something like that. I can't remember.
Oh, that's
what
right.
It's
that's right.
And all the land is protected. You can only walk in certain areas.
And then there's a whole series of some astronomy gear up there.
Yes.
What's interesting is I was reading about this. I don't know when the last time you're up there, Laura. I don't think you went up this trip, did you?
Mm-mm, no.
There's actually one of the buildings up there. Its main job is to track all the stuff in space, all the space junk.
Awesome.
So I was like, that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure it gets boring after
I was going to say, that's got to be the most exciting job in Hawaii. It's like everyone else, like surf instructor. Oh, I look at shards of debris, you know, 13 miles up in space.
Or maybe there's, you know, people that are looking for sharks.
Yeah. I could do that part.
Okay. Yes, you could. Stay out.
I would be like, it's not worth it.
Although I will tell you this funny story. And then I'm sorry, then we'll move on.
Okay.
South of where we were, you know where mm-hmm. we were. There's this area that you drive. Did you drive down to that area down south of... kind of near Little Beach.
I don't think so. No.
We get out there in the car, and it looks like the moon.
You mean the lava field that's down there?
Yes.
I've been there once.
And then we go out there, and my wife and I look at the lava field, like, what is going on here? And there's the sign that I sent you, and I think I tweeted this was the sharks.
Oh, that's
right.
Where that was.
And then we turn around, and there's these gentlemen in military gear with automatic weapons.
What?
I was like, this is like some Jurassic Park crazy stuff going on down there.
Had the sharks made it onto land?
They were, apparently they were animal control for some animals.
Oh,
I don't know I think they were shooting goats because they eat chickens, or chickens because they eat goats or something.
It's a little anticlimactic. I'll take your land sharks, please.
Yeah. Anyway, all right, let's get back. If you have any questions about that, let me know.
I'll link out to Haleakala.
Haleakala.
Mm-hmm. You're getting there.
I need you to go to Maui, Jeffrey.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
You will really like it.
Is there skiing in the mountain? Is there skiing in the mountain? I don't know if there is. Or snowboarding.
I don't know.
There may be somewhere in Hawaii. I mean, there's a mountain. And it's cold enough.
It looks really cool. It does not look like what you expect. I brought up some... It looks like the moon or Mars.
It does. When you get up to the top, you're like... And I read somewhere that on one of the islands in Hawaii, because some of them do have mountains like this, there actually is an outpost where people are living as if they're on Mars. Do you know where that is?
No, I don't know which island that is.
But you've heard of that,
right?
But
I have, yes. And it is one of the mountains on the Hawaiian Islands where they're pretending to be on Mars.
Right. We need to go find that.
We do.
Yeah, I want to know where that is. So anyway, here we are. So yeah, we've had a busy April, came back just back a few days ago. Laura, I don't know when you got back, but I got back. Here we are. We're getting ready for E3.
Oh, yes, we are.
We've got a lot going on. Jeff, do you want to go through some of the headlines? Because we've got E3 coming up. We have an Inside Xbox show coming up in a few weeks. Next week? Next Friday?
Yes.
Which is, What is the date? The date is the 11th. We are going to bring this very show, back to Mixer.
That's right.
So you can see us.
A live show.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to share this with you in the room and the audience. I like to have guests. We've had Graham on. We've had Phil Spencer on. I have reached out to Mike Ibarra. He has not responded yet. So if you're listening to this and you want Mike to come on the show, let him know that I mentioned it. I'll reach out to him again. So I'm putting a little community pressure on him.
I see.
So
it's called using the bully pulpit.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it?
Okay. If you were the president. It's the same principle.
Okay.
It's a thing.
Okay. I don't know where to take it from there, but I'm gonna hand it over to you, and you're gonna read some of the headlines.
Oh my god.
We'll talk about what we're playing in a minute too.
All right. So I took a trip this week.
Where'd you go?
Back in time to the old west, where I saw Red Dead Redemption 2 official trailer number 3. This is something you want to watch if you haven't seen it. It does appear there is a person in there that you will be very familiar from the original Red Dead Redemption. If you're staying spoiler free, then I won't go any further than that. But it definitely
Seth.
Seth was something else in it. I got to go back and play through. I mean,
That it's enhanced.
Yes, I know, and it looks beautiful. We talked about this.
Yeah.
And I really need to go back through because clearly this takes place before the events of Red Dead Redemption 1. And so, there's a lot of familiar names. You're hearing things like Dutch and Dutch's gang. And so it looks like there's a lot of that. So obviously it looks incredible. It looks beautiful. There's a story I've been reading on IGN where it appears they got to play or at least got to see an extended segment. There's no video of it, but even their descriptions are, that's what they do. It's the written word.
Well, I think I said this on one of my other ones. A friend of mine, a longtime friend of mine who, Jeff, you've met.
Yeah, yeah.
You haven't. He's actually, he did the audio for the game and he is in the game.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I can't really say too much, and I've seen a lot.
Is his audio in the game, or is
his
persona is in the game?
Yes.
All of the things?
Yeah, so we'll talk more about that when we get closer to the Red Dead Redemption 2 launch. I can't tell you much more, but I'm just as excited. You have every reason to be excited, I'll just say that.
Well, we all know that team delivers. So I've got, before we get to E3, and before we get to Red Dead Redemption, which is coming out in October, I think it's the 26th, what about this weekend? What are you doing this weekend?
What are you doing this weekend?
Because do you have money? Are you out of money? That's okay, because there's
never been...
You
waiting for payday, Jeffrey?
Oh, you better believe it.
Living paycheck to paycheck again, are you?
Well, not for the last time. There is... this is a great weekend to not spend any money. This is your value conscience. This is your deal corner. Crazy Larry might have had something to do with this.
Maybe.
Three games.
Un de trois.
That are free for just this weekend if you are a member of Xbox Live Gold. And of course you are if you're listening to the show. One of them is XCOM 2, one of my absolute favorite games of the last few years. If you've been wanting to try it out, if you've heard about it, you should try it out. Make sure you name all of the characters on your team after your friends. Then you want to keep them alive. Mm-hmm. And then when they don't, you call them and you say you died because you got shot by a brute. It happens. another game, also free this weekend, For Honor.
Yes.
So if that's a game you've been thinking about, you've looked at, you've heard at, because they've kept that game going, Ubisoft has really continued to support it, this is a time to jump in and try it. And one more game. They're all three very different. Just Cause 3. So this is a game that has been enhanced for Xbox One
X. I gotta go. I love that
craziness.
Game.
Yeah, this is exactly the type of game that you love open world games, mm-hmm.
and this is just chaos.
And you love raw
and chaos.
You can surf on a car that's going through the air and jump off to a helicopter and grapple to something else and then blow a bunch of stuff up.
Another
that's
day at the
game.
Office.
That's just and you can try it out for free over this weekend if you're on Xbox Live Gold.
Now I've got a post on MajorNelson.com that has all this, right?
Have you seen? There's one that sums up all three,
yep.
has all the links.
Yep.
I'll link to that.
It's just one stop because I know that people, I don't know that they call lazy links, they used to call them back in the day. I don't know if they do that anymore.
No, it's.
Can we bring it back?
The links started complaining.
Right.
They're not lazy. They're right. just.
So that's politically incorrect?
It's possible that they're just there's a good medical reason why they don't have.
Okay, I understand. You know, they have a note from home. Okay. Yeah.
Another thing that you should jump onto very quickly, if you're listening to this before May 8th and you're interested in Dark Souls, of course you are.
Mm-hmm.
There is a Dark Souls remastered, so you know that's coming out pretty soon, a network test. And the way that's going to work, the game itself is coming out May 25th. But there's going to be a network test that's happening next on the 11th and on the 12th. But you can't just say, oh, it's happening today. Let me download it. Nope. They want only the in true Dark Souls fashion. It is going to be a little bit complicated. You want to download it now between now and May 8th at 11:59 Pacific time. So you've got a few days. You can download the Dark Souls Remastered Network Test Client on the Microsoft Store. You can probably just pop that into your search engine of choice or onto your Xbox One. You download it. Then when... What are you watching? Are you that bored, Larry?
No, I opened a page up here in a video.
He's just starting to watch YouTube.
You know, it's just great. I can just click
not a big Dark Souls fan, Larry.
Just click on this here to mute that tab.
That's a new feature on the April update, which I had yesterday. Way to bring that in. So anyway, the network test itself is going to run on May 11th and 12th from like 6 to midnight each day Pacific time. So anyway, if it's something you're looking into, you want to know how good does Dark Souls look now? It's been like close to 10 years, I think, since it first debuted on Xbox 360. Well, you're going to get to find out and you don't have to pay a penny. One last free thing, because I told you it really is the deal corner.
Yeah.
What about your Xbox Live games with gold? Well, we're into May.
What
it's
about
gonna be
them,
May.
Jeffrey?
It's going to be May. It is May though, so too late. We should have done a show last week. The games with gold. So live now, Super Mega Baseball 2. Look at that. Whitey Ford, Hall of Famer Whitey.
Going, it's out of here.
What team do you like? There's no team. Are you a Sox fan?
Well, no. What happened was when I was growing up in Connecticut, because Connecticut's halfway between New York and Boston.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
My dad was a Yankees fan, and my grandfather was a Red Sox fan.
Oh. Ooh.
So I was like, when I was a little boy, they're like, well, which one do you like? And I said, the Mets.
Did you really?
Yes.
That's a good answer, I think.
Oh,
so you're
man.
A Mets fan.
Yeah, I actually have been a Mets fan.
Have you ever been to Citi Field?
Oh, I have not been to Citi, but I had spent a lot of time out at Shea under the flight path.
Flushing,
in
New
Flushing,
York.
New York.
Beautiful Flushing. Citi Field looks nice. I've never been there. Whenever we go to New York and you fly into JFK, you drive right by it.
Yeah.
But I've never been there. Anyway. needless to say, Super Mega Baseball 2.
Have you been to Citi Field, Laura?
No, I have not.
Okay. Wait, did you? What? Who are you a fan of baseball? Are you baseball?
Growing up, it was the Texas Rangers.
Of course it was. Mm. Of course it was. I figured it was.
Big Rafael Palmeiro fan. I'm trying to think who was on the Rangers when you were a kid.
Rodriguez.
Oh, A-Rod.
Yeah.
wow.
Hey, well, you know, he's a troubled soul.
Yes.
And then the free Xbox 360 title, which of course is playable on Xbox One through the magic of backward compatibility.
Yes.
Streets of Rage. And this version has multiple Streets of Rage games. They actually conjugated that properly. It's not Streets of Rages. Street of Rages. It's Streets of Rage. And Streets of Rage 2 was like my favorite game, like growing up. One of my favorite. I love a good beat 'em up. That one was really fun.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, I think you do go into a baseball stadium at one point.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Yeah. It's very 2D. I recommend checking it out. It costs you nothing if you're a gold member. So
the baseball game has Home Run Derby. Did you play that as a kid?
Like When you, how, what?
All you're doing is trying to get home runs, just swinging and swinging. And you played it, right?
Kind of like A-Rod.
Laura played it at Home Run Derby.
Of course I did.
Is that like a video
game? That's a really,
no, it's a mode.
It's a mode like where you just try and shoot for the fences. Yeah,
oh, okay. I thought it was like some sort of like board game you were talking about. No. Stratomatic baseball, which I
had friends of mine that played that in high school. And they would laugh at me because I was playing D&D. I'm like, it's the same thing.
It's D&D for baseball.
It's D&D for baseball.
Yeah. I had that when I was like 12, but I couldn't get anyone to play with
me. Did you play Stratomatic?
No, I didn't.
Because I figured you'd love that because it's all filled with stats and numbers.
I probably would.
And you should try that.
It's like a baseball RPG.
Yeah, it's exactly.
I love RPGs.
I should have said it's a baseball Diablo, and then you would get it right
now.
But that's not really
accurate. Where can I buy
it? That's not what it is at all.
One last game that I wanted to talk about was Paladins. And this is a game that's made from the good people at Hi-Rez. And this looks really cool. And it is coming out of the game preview program, or it's leaving open beta on May 8th. So about the time you're listening to that. And this is a game that has like become like a really cool competitive league and looks really, as someone who plays a ton of Overwatch, including this morning during a conference call, my boss is probably not listening, this sort of looks really, this looks like a game I would want to get into. A similar aesthetic and obviously very popular. So you can check that out. Paladins, May 8th, 1.0. And oh God, yet another free game that we, man, this
really?
Is really.
There's more?
Your new currency is time. It's not money anymore.
It's always been. That is the the most valuable thing in the world is time.
Yes.
Because you can never get it back.
That's true.
Oh, that's true. Fortnite Season 4. Mm-hmm. I'm sure if you play Fortnite, you know that. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, hopefully the time at which I'm getting killed by John Wicks is soon replaced by getting killed by whatever the other new popular skin is from Season 4. I usually get killed by a John Wick looking character.
I see.
Yes. Anyway, so that's pretty popular right now. And then just one other game, DLC. Looks pretty interesting. Super Lucky's Tale, of course, a Xbox Play Anywhere title that we released last fall. Fun platformer. There is a new, like, kind of 80s themed DLC. The Guardian Trials is now available.
You know, I love my 80s.
Yes. And of course, Super Lucky's Tale is part of Xbox Game Pass. If you play it, you enjoy it, and you decide you want the Guardian Trials, it's just $4.99. And after that, really just a lot of other ID at Xbox titles. I can just rattle through those if you'd like.
Why not?
Why not?
Quickly.
You thought about it. Okay, Bounce Rescue.
Go.
Oh man, I really scrolled wrong. Drive on Moscow.
Seconds.
You've been to Moscow. City of Brass, Aquamoto Racing Utopia, Dungeon Rushers Crawler RPG.
Just go over to my blog and
those.
Check it out.
Inksplosion, Outbreak the Nightmare. Those are the games.
You know what I love? I love when we travel, you travel, I travel, Laura travels. Usually when Laura travels, she'll go like home and she'll bring back barbecue.
Sometimes.
Right? When you go down to Austin, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
What?
You didn't bring us barbecue.
I didn't bring back barbecue.
He was in Austin.
You were in Austin.
Last week.
Yeah.
And you didn't bring back.
I was literally there for less than 24 hours.
It's in the airport.
I brought barbecue back.
It's in the airport.
In my tummy. And it was so good. I went to Rudy's.
Was there any room considering you spent so
Here's
much
what
time
I did.
There's Torchy's?
There's three things you have to have when you, actually four, when you go to Austin.
There
and
are
this
many
is mine.
Things.
I need
okay.
to get Tex-Mex from someplace
Where'd
good.
Where'd you go?
Went to a place called La Condesa.
Okay.
It was okay.
Not been there. But I can give you some good restaurant recommendations.
Yes, please.
Yes, you can.
Then you have to get breakfast tacos at Torchy's.
Yes, you do.
You need to get barbecue.
Yes.
And then on the flight home, I need to just anger the entire
plane. Here
he goes. Here
he goes.
Because there was nothing better at 38,000 feet than a Schlotzky's Turkey Original.
No.
So I flew in at night. I met some friends for dinner at La Condesa. Then the next morning, I was there with Richard Foggy, who's the design director from Undead Labs. And we were down at Rooster Teeth showing off. And I can link to that video, actually, which went
Please
up.
Do.
At 90 minutes. If you want to see 90 minutes of gameplay with Ashley and Bernie playing co-op.
How,
it was really
how are
fun.
Those guys? I haven't seen
they're
them
great.
In a while.
Some of my favorite
people. When was the last time I had Bernie on the show? Like 3 years ago, remember?
Ages.
That was before I was working.
No, was
yes.
it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Really?
It was ages ago.
Yeah.
Oh, Bernie,
it's
we
been
gotta
too
get
long.
You, yeah, we gotta get you on again.
Yeah.
Wow.
So obviously I love going down and seeing those folks. A lot of great people down there, huge fans of State of Decay.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a great interview, and again, I'll link out to that. But you know, then we went out for bar. Every time I go down to visit those guys, they're like, let's go for barbecue. So we went to Rudy's, and then I got to the airport. And I had just eaten, but I got Schlotzky's anyway.
See, I could I could live down there. Because
I could die down there.
Because it's the exact opposite for Seattle. Like when people come to Seattle, they're like, oh, we want to go out for sushi and Asian food. Mm-hmm. And I don't do that. I do not prefer that type of culinary.
Well, that's fine. You would eat very well in Texas.
In Texas,
you would.
Yeah. I think it's the best food city. Like, you know, I mean, obviously New York has everything and LA does as well. But I would say outside of those two, like Austin is just the best.
Yes, it is. I can definitely give you some better recommendations.
Do you ever see that episode of Futurama where Bender becomes like a human?
No.
And he, for like a day, and in that day he completely wrecks his body because he's just smoking and drinking and eating everything. That would be me in Austin if I lived there. I would not do so well.
Well, I'll give you a pro tip for next time you go to the Austin airport.
Yes.
The Salt Lick Barbecue sells frozen briskets there.
I have brought one back in the past. Okay, I brought one back for E, and he smoked it.
Well,
and
then
it
you
amazing.
Should have brought us one. There's no excuses.
Nothing.
I hadn't seen you were gone. I haven't seen
you in a long time.
Whatever. Yeah. All right, I'll just have to go back.
We are. We're kind of chugging through the show here. Laura, have you had a chance? I know you were out. Did you get a chance to play anything?
I played a few things, I do want to talk about some news.
Okay.
That I'm excited about, which is Dragon Age 2.
Yes.
Is now backwards compatible.
Yes.
Which is super exciting. It was a very, very good game. So if you missed it or didn't get a chance to finish it.
I never finished it either.
Now you can play it. Yeah. Backwards compatible on Xbox One.
Yes. So good.
And that was something people had been asking for quite a while. Because I believe the first Dragon Age was already there.
Mm-hmm.
Dragon
Age 2.
And people have been asking it. And you know what? It's there.
It's there.
Play it.
Hooray.
Enjoy.
Okay. So what I've been playing, I've played 3 games. I haven't had too much time to play as I've been traveling. But the 3 I'll talk about is 1, continuing to play Sea of Thieves.
Yes. Mm.
Someone gave me a great tip on Twitter about how to find the map when you're sailing the small version of the ship. No, you don't go climbing up the crow's nest.
Turn around and look down.
There's so when you're at the you do have to walk a little bit further. When you're at the wheel, steering the ship.
Yep.
If you need to know where you're going, you can just turn 180 degrees around, walk a few steps backwards, and look down, and you'll see the map table.
Mm-hmm.
But what you have to do is you have to orient the map so that you can see it from that angle.
Right, of course.
So you have to get the map ready, and then you can see the map when you're steering the ship. So that helps out.
My niece and I were playing last month, she showed me that. And I was like, oh, wow, that's actually a great tip. And the rare guys obviously know, but they didn't mention it to me when I was over there.
No, I'm sure they designed it that way.
Yeah, I'm sure they did.
Collecting more treasure chests, unlocking more missions, doing the different types of quests.
Yes.
It's pretty fun.
Yes.
We should get together.
We should. We have not.
I want to coast off of you because you're way further in, you know, in terms of your ratings than I am. And you have access, I'm sure, to some good.
What level are you? Do you know?
I don't remember.
I'm like 15, 11, 12.
Have you unlocked all of the different types of missions?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Cool. If you want to play weekend, I'm bringing my laptop. I'm going to be out of town, but I'm bringing my laptop with me.
We can play together.
I have it downloaded. It runs beautifully on my Surface Book 2.
Yes, it does. In fact, I'm playing it right now in front of this. No, I'm not.
I would believe it.
I'm not. Anyway, that's a good tip. Thank you, Laura.
Yep. And the other game I've been playing is Fortnite Battle Royale Season 3, and now Season 4 is out.
Yep.
So you can jump back into that.
You got sucked into the Fortnite phenomenon.
I've been playing it a little bit.
A little bit.
Okay. I'm still building my skill sets, sort of catching up with the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Well, I got number 6.
That's good.
Oh, wow.
Not too bad.
Well done.
It's not too bad. That's my highest in the past couple weeks.
That's. I played the new, speaking of that, PUBG has the Miramar map.
Yes, they do. It's in the test server.
Test server. That's what it is. Yeah. So I got number 2 on that.
Awesome. Nice job.
You know, wait a minute. Stop that, Larry. I don't want to be Mr. 1-Up. That's not what I meant by this. I just wanted to say that Miramar is out, or it's in test server.
What you meant to say is you finished in 6, and I'm the one who killed you.
No.
Laura.
That would be hilarious if all of a sudden Major Nelson comes around the corner and shoots me.
And then
there would be some text messages.
He has an animation glitch. No. You know, he's doing. There was a controversy in that. Like someone did that in an Overwatch League match.
Right.
This is part of the game.
Right.
And he got booed.
Did he?
That's when you have a live studio audience. It's my favorite player, Carpe. And I was like,
little
collar.
Ouch. What else you got?
And the other game I jump back into was Halo Wars 2.
Yeah.
If you remember that game.
Mm-hmm. Looking great.
It still is. Yeah, I needed to scratch the RTS itch.
Yeah.
And that one does it really well.
Good.
It's really, really fun.
Good.
I should download that to my laptop as well.
Yep, so I've been playing more of the campaign there. I haven't finished the campaign yet, but really getting into it.
Oh.
So if you need your real-time strategy fix,
then that's the way to do it.
I highly recommend Halo Wars 2.
That is the exact way to do it.
And of course, because it's Xbox Play Anywhere, if you're one of these people who says, I can only play an RTS on a computer.
Done.
And I kind of agree with you. You know, some, yeah, we all have our preferences. Although actually, the controls are really good on Xbox. You can do that. You just take your pick. Whatever you like. We're here for you.
What else you play?
Larry's just rolling his eyes.
No, not at all. I love the program. I love the fact I got Sea of Thieves on here. Mm-hmm. I was working through Voodoo Vince on here on my Surface Book 2. So I love it.
And that's all I've been playing.
You are. Thank you for that. For me, I finished up Far Cry 5.
So did I.
Yeah, without me.
Yeah, without me.
I saw
me.
That tweet.
You start. God, we've gotten real. Just call me, Larry.
I know. No, I was like, because you and I, oh, we could play this together.
We did.
To be fair.
We did some crazy stuff together. We punched a bull to death with our bare hands.
Wow.
And, together.
That's some bonding.
And Jeffrey was mauled by a turkey.
They actually had to nerf the turkeys. And they, you know what? It was way overdue. Those turkeys were OP.
Well, goodness.
If there's actually a mission that you have to do with the turkeys, and you understand why they were so OP.
They just, so powerful. Turkey mission?
That's all I'm going to say.
No, I didn't do that mission.
All right, now I got to go back. Turkey
I too beat it, I didn't know the mysteries of the OP turkeys.
You need your revenge is what you need.
It's called Thanksgiving. Yeah. But yes.
Anyway, so finished that. A lot of fun. Like I said, been playing a little bit of PUBG, getting back into a few other things. But that's I'm looking for that next single player experience.
Well, you know what?
I know
it's coming up.
I know that you're in the middle of God of War.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
It's good. So I got to work to help promote three or four of the God of War titles back when I was over at Sony. I think I might be in the credits on a few of them.
Back in the day,
in the ancient past. And so I'm very invested in that world and in Kratos, and I've gotten now really into Norse mythology between catching up on Thor. Mm-hmm. I was catching up on all the Marvel movies I hadn't seen before.
Have you seen Infinity War?
Of course.
Okay. You've
always been a little bit of a Viking guy.
Yeah, yes, you watched that Viking
only
program.
Only when the Eagles are beating them in the playoffs. Yeah.
No, but you watched that Viking program, didn't you?
No.
And you went to Iceland.
I did go to Iceland.
That's true. And you told us about the different traditions that the Iceland people have.
Oh yeah, Christmas. About the Christmas dwarves.
Oh, that's right,
elves.
The Christmas thing. That's
yes.
right.
Yeah.
So yeah,
which
you,
is amazing.
You do. You
all right, I guess I didn't realize it. You know, it's one of those things until you've pointed it out. I'm super into Viking culture. And we do the clap. We do the clap at the Sounders matches, like the hey, anyway, you have to be there. It doesn't really work when
it's only one person.
Video. Or yeah, one person does not a Viking clap make. Anyway, it's really a lot of the things that are mentioned in like Thor Ragnarok, like with mm-hmm. the Bifrost and the whatever, you know, the different gods and all these things and the realms are mentioned in a lot of different places, and it's just a very different take on it. So I'm enjoying that. I'm also trying to plow through it really quickly because I'm super excited for State of Decay 2. I've gotten to play a bunch of it. We played at PAX.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And then I got to play during
that's co-op.
We did an event where a lot of media and creators got to play. And so I played quite a bit there, and also on a live stream for on Mixer, on the Xbox Mixer channel. And I just love State of Decay. I love that it's not a zombie basher. Mm-hmm. It's a how do you survive? And like the zombies are the they're an impediment to long-term survival. And of course, if you're you know careless, you're going to get ripped limb from limb. But I just love the idea of it's not about, you know, one person going through and headshotting their way through the apocalypse, but rather, you know, what's the sustainable way to keep as many people alive as possible? And there's some just really cool mechanics. And so if you liked the original State of Decay, if you like Sims, mm-hmm. Maybe if you like The Sims, I really love what the team has done. The game has come a long way. I'm going to link out in the show notes to the playthrough with Ashley and Bernie from Rooster Teeth, along with Richard Foggy, the design director from Undead Labs.
I may stream it when it comes out next week. When's
yeah, this? Yeah. Well, the game comes out. If you get the deluxe edition, which includes your DLCs, they've already announced two updates. That'll be on May 18th. But
right.
If you're picking up the standard edition, which is only $29.99, or if you have Xbox Game Pass, May 22nd, it'll be when you get to play that. You'll start to see media and creators put some footage out and some live streams and stuff probably a week before that. So you'll get a hold of it sooner rather than later.
Yes.
It looks really good. Oh, what else? Oh, Far Cry. Of course, we've beaten that, and I'm playing. Oh, I forgot to tell you. I got while you were gone. I sort of pretended I was you.
I know you were on the show.
I put on a paisley shirt. I put on some Allbirds.
Yes.
And I snuck my way into the Shadow of the Tomb Raider reveal event.
That's right. Mm. That's right. It was on the show.
And so I got to go in and I got to play about an hour.
It was down in LA.
In LA. Yep. Nice. Of Shadow of the Tomb Raider on Xbox One X, which was awesome. And you know me, I like the Tomb Raider games. Mm-hmm. I know you really enjoyed Rise of the Tomb Raider. I've actually started playing through it again on Windows 10. Just to sort of get a feel for it. Now I'm like hooked back into it again. Shadow looked really cool. There's some new mechanics. If you just tell me you're giving me more Tomb Raider, that sounds cool. But there's sort of like a 3-game arc that is like getting Lara to the Lara we know.
Right.
Like the mm-hmm. first Tomb Raider 2013 was sort of like, here's a fresh-faced young college student, you know, that is put into crazy circumstances and she was lucky to get out alive. And then Rise of the Tomb Raider, she started getting a little more like, you know, wanting to take ownership of like her family's legacy.
It's called character development.
Yeah, I'm not good with that. or brevity for that matter. But and then in this game, now I'm like, whoa, Lara, you need to slow your roll a little bit. Like some of the stuff that happens in this...
No spoilers.
I'm not sure. Yeah. Well, I mean, it's a lot of people talked about it, but I think we're, you know, is she going too far? Like, I'm very curious to see like where Lara, like, is her pursuit of raiding tombs like consuming her? I don't know. I'm concerned.
We'll find out.
Yes, we should.
But it was fun, and I can't wait to play more. And that game is coming out this fall. I think we said September. So very much looking forward to Shadow of the Tomb Raider.
Yeah. E3's coming up. E3's coming up.
Oh, I know.
We are we're just a little bit over a month away, Laura.
Wow.
I'll be there. Jeff will be there. We actually announced details while you and I were gone. We've got it at the Microsoft Theater.
Oh, that's right.
Right. Yep. Which is right in LA Live,
mm-hmm.
Which is where the Video Game Awards were last year. Jeff Keighley's, I call them the Keighleys.
The Golden Keighley.
The Golden Keighley Awards. So we're excited that Jeff will be there. I'll be there. Laura, you may or may not be there. It doesn't look like you are.
I am working out details. Sad face. We'll see.
Hopefully you'll be there. And you dear folks, because there's a lot of folks that are chosen for FanFest. All the FanFest details were revealed. Most of them were revealed, I mm-hmm. should say. So we're looking forward to seeing a bunch of you guys there. We'll be doing an episode of Inside Xbox down there, Jeff and I.
That's going to be fun.
Oh, we'd love that on-site stuff.
It's just, there'll be a bunch of people
I'm going to bring my microphone.
So much to talk about.
Are you? You're special.
Well, I had it on the last show. Yeah. People seem to like it, so.
Oh, that's so cool.
It's you. It's very you.
Thank you.
Plus, you got that Major's Minute in. You did it. That was hard to, I like the fact that you were able to do that live and nail it.
It
in
was,
60 seconds.
Well, yeah. Well, it's funny that we brought Major's Minute back in this, such an interesting way that when they told me that, hey, let's do Major's Minute, I'm like, okay, why not? So it was fun to do that. But there we go.
Some exciting stuff coming up.
E3's coming up, and I can't tell you, we can't say more about that, but of course it'll be on Mixer and all that. You can watch it at home and stream it. And I'm actually working on something cool for it that I can't talk about right now.
Of course you are.
Oh, wait a minute.
Of course you are.
Oh, there's the headline. Damn it.
No, it's fine. It's people know that you're not gonna, you know.
Go ahead,
talk about
careful.
It. You're talking about the things that you're doing.
Yeah, I've got a little project that I'm working on that is kind of cool. So it's anyway, always working on something new, something different, something borrowed, something blue. What? Wait, what?
Where are we?
All right, we're gonna continue going along on the show here. We're rapidly closing towards the end of our time together in terms of this hour. Because
just this hour. I was like, wait, what do I not know?
Now we've got to name the game.
We do.
Yeah, which is really bizarre because the name of the game was like done
over a month ago.
It was back in March.
Yes.
Which seems so far away. And you've got the details for the name of the game, right?
Have the prizes like collected interest while they were sitting
they
in
possibly
in
have they
possibly
all right so
you
why don't
find
we
find out later.
We've got the last one that we played here, so why don't we go ahead and play that, and then you can tell us who won, Laura.
That's right. Okay, let's play the name of the game from last time. Name name the game from last time.
March-ish.
But to be clear, it was our last audio-only podcast. It wasn't the video podcast.
Because we didn't do one then.
That's right.
In fact, we told you during the show.
That's correct. We did remind you.
Should we do one on the next video podcast?
We should talk about that.
Okay. We'll figure that out. All right. So anyway, go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. So the name of the game from last time was Surviving Mars.
Yeah.
Which I have not played yet, but I hear is really cool.
It looks like really hockey.
Wait a minute. Is it Surviving Mars or Surviving a Volcano on Hawaii?
Mm. I just beat you to that joke, Larry. It's like I'm not even here.
Oh, hi, Jeffrey.
All right. So bringing us back on track here. Who won?
Yes,
thank you very much for all of your entries, but we have one winner, and his name is Don from Tempe, Arizona.
Tempe, Arizona. Also, looks similar to Mars, I'm sure.
Possibly. Maybe his firsthand experience.
Yep.
His gamer tag is ODST1X.
That's a fantastic gamer tag.
That is a good
gamer tag.
That is good. A good tag.
Yeah, that's pretty good. All right, Don, what have you won?
What have you won, Don?
Big basket of prizes for you.
Oh.
That's right. They come in baskets these days.
They do.
I've got a copy of Terra Supreme Founders Pack.
Does it have all that like stuff in it, like paper when you get a
cellophane?
Yeah, like a
cellophane. Of course it does.
Okay,
and a big bow.
Yeah, it's gonna make all these crinkly noises.
That's really those crinkly noises is what sells the whole thing. All right, you also get a copy of Battlezone and City of Brass. Plus, you get a copy of Super Lucky's Tale, plus the Gilly Island DLC and the new Guardians Trials DLC.
Right.
So all of it.
Literally
all together.
If we've talked about it, it seems to be here.
Possibly.
How does that work?
I don't know. I might have some connections.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, you also get a copy of Impact Winter, Extinction, MX versus ATV All Out.
Yep.
That's not all. You also get a copy of Batman, The Enemy
Within.
Wait
a minute. How many games
the
is
complete
this?
Season?
They really did acquire interest.
They might have acquired interest, indeed.
This is like a dozen games.
This is a big basket of games.
Yeah.
Forgot to mention the big part.
The big
the basket.
Part. The big
Wait,
part.
It's getting bigger?
It gets bigger.
Wait, what?
You also get a copy of Sea of Thieves.
Ooh. Yes. Play Anywhere title.
And?
What?
A copy of Far Cry 5.
What?
I know.
Wow.
Your next couple of months are sorted out here.
Pretty much locked up here.
Wow.
But that's not all.
There's even more?
Included in all of this.
Yes.
And the very bottom of that basket is an Xbox wireless controller.
Yes.
The Combat Tech Special Edition.
We need to make sure we're taking care of you.
Somebody named ODST1X is going to like that controller.
That
Absolutely.
Is perfect. That is perfect. Thank
so
you, Laura.
Congratulations, Don. You hit the big basket.
And then there's people listening right now that are saying, gee whiz, how do I win?
Exactly. How do you win the big basket of
prizes?
Well,
you know what? The good news is Laura is going to tell you
now.
That's
right. We're going to do another Name the Game. And it is really easy to play this game. All you have to do is listen to the sound effects that I'm about to play and then send us an email with what game you think those sounds are from. Pretty simple, right?
Right.
Cool. So shall we roll the tape?
Oh, yes. I'm sorry. I was trying to get my computer connected here. Yes, I'm ready. I'm ready.
Larry's not ready to hit the button.
You ready?
Here we go. All right, so that was Name the Game for this week.
Yay.
If you think you know what game those sounds are from,
right?
Just send us an email.
And you could win.
And you could win the big basket of prizes.
Mm-hmm.
Send us an email, lollipop@xbox.com, and ccmajor@xbox.com.
Hello.
It's that easy.
Hello.
And if you can hear our voice, you can enter the game.
Yeah. That's all you need to do.
That's all you need to do.
It's all you need to do. Don't hit us up on Twitter because that doesn't count.
That's right.
The only way you can enter is sending us an email.
That's right. We don't accept entries over Twitter or on Xbox Live.
Or via the U.S. mail system.
That is correct.
Right.
Physical mail.
Physical mail, no.
No. But email, that's the way.
That's the way. Exactly. A lot of people don't even use email anymore.
What do they use?
I know a lot of the younger...
Telepathy.
They text. Snapchat. Don't send it to us on Snapchat.
No.
Are you on Snapchat, Larry?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Larry is.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah, I'm on Snapchat. I enjoy it less and less because I enjoy
Instagram stories.
Yeah,
that's over. I only use Snapchat to, believe it or not, to talk to my mom. That's how we talk back and forth in my whole family.
Oh, really?
We have a little group one, and it's mostly just sending rude bitmojis back and forth. But I talk to my mom now more than I ever have, just because
my mom has mastered animated GIFs.
Oh,
which is
mine's not on.
Wow.
That.
Yeah,
occasionally
that's
send
great.
Something.
Yeah, yeah, I don't understand how she's doing this.
Yeah,
so
good for her.
But does your mom text you and send you animated GIFs and whatnot?
She texts me, and then she taught me how to use WhatsApp.
What is she? What do you mean she taught you? What does that mean?
I hadn't used WhatsApp before.
Okay.
And then she and my father went to China on a trip.
Right.
And she's like, we're going to communicate with you over WhatsApp.
Right.
I was like, I don't have WhatsApp.
Right.
How do I use this?
Right.
And so she had to give me instructions about how we could communicate.
And
over
did it work?
WhatsApp. It did. But it turns out they just use text messages when they're over there.
Right. So. Yeah. It turns out that you don't need that.
Yeah.
So.
So now I'm on WhatsApp, but I don't use it.
But you think, delete.
We'll see.
Right. Delete. All right. I Jeffrey, you okay over there? You looks like
I'm doing fine.
You're checking your phone. It looks like you're ready.
I'm downloading WhatsApp. I want these barbecue pics. I'm sure you're.
That's
you're,
right.
I'm downloading WhatsApp too. I'm gonna ask your mom to give me China updates. Is she still there?
No.
Oh, okay.
They're back.
And my in-laws use WhatsApp too. They go to China all the time.
Do they?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just for fun.
I actually have one of the problems I'm running into, and it happens with people that I deal with on a regular basis, like you, Jeff, especially you, Laura, because you and I have known each other so long, is you and I have way too many communication touch points.
Yeah, we do.
Right? And Jeff, even you and I mean, we go to text, but...
Except that when you don't text me and then you later complain, like, I wanted to play Far Cry with you.
So maybe
like,
it's
well,
not
why
enough.
Why didn't you text me?
Well, I mean, like I was talking to Laura, we've got, you know, we've got the Facebook.
Yeah.
Gmail and just every Outlook and just every possible Skype for business, text messaging. I mean, the list goes on and on.
It's unheard of.
Instagram.
It's untenable.
It is. It just doesn't scale. It doesn't scale. All right. If you guys don't have anything else, we're going to wrap the show up.
And on that note,
we're
all doomed.
We have to get ready because we have to go and do makeup because we have a live show next week, next Friday. We're going to do the show live in Mixer.
Doing it live.
I should probably get a haircut. I've resorted to hats.
Yeah, I want to talk. We'll talk about that off the air.
Okay.
We'll talk about that. What is that? Washington? You're wearing
It's a Seattle Sounders. It was like limited.
Oh, you're going to turn it sideways too?
No, I was showing you the side.
Did you see that little?
Yeah, I did.
I wasn't going for like Fresh Prince of Bel Air.
Oh, yes. Well, too late.
Credits.
Too late. Too late.
All right.
Too late.
Can you just
bend that brim for me?
I won't do it.
Just a little bit.
I took the sticker off just for you. I'm team no sticker.
All right, we'll see you. We're going to do the show next. When are we doing it? Like 10 a.m. or 10:30 or 8:30? Do we know?
Let me bring that up real quick.
I'll check my calendar.
We're going to do the show next Friday. That's May 11th on Mixer. Go to mixer.com/MajorNelson. It's a live show. We do
10 a.m. Pacific.
10 a.m. Pacific. That's 1 o'clock Eastern, and that's sometime later in the day, UK. And
it's earlier. It's really early in Australia.
It is very early. So
stay up late.
But don't worry about it. If you miss the show, I pull off the video, or I put the video up as video on demand. I take the audio, slap it into my podcast.
We come to you.
Yeah, it's wherever you are, whatever you want to do, we'll be there.
WhatsApp.
And remember,
Snapchat.
Hit up Xbox Quick on Twitter and tell me you want him to be on the show, because
that's right.
He asked him to be on the show, and he hasn't responded to me an email. So... Bully pulpit.
Yeah, there. See, I taught you something.
All right, gang. We'll talk to you next time, Laura. If they can find Laura on social media at,
you can find me on Twitter at Laura Lollipop.
That's really the only way you need to find her. Don't That's text right. her. Don't WhatsApp her.
Yeah. I don't know how to use WhatsApp, so I wouldn't respond.
If you have any complaints about the show or anything Xbox related, feel free to reach out to
at Jeff Rubenstein. It's funny because it's really starting to happen. I've solved a couple issues.
Have
this
you?
Week. Yeah.
Thank you for calling tech support. Yeah. My name is Jeffrey. How can I help you?
Yeah. So. I'm just waiting by the phone.
So, all right, we'll talk to you guys. We'll see you next week on Mixer.
That's right.
We'll bring our very best selves to you. We'll talk to you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.